Hello everyone and welcome back. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. With Adobe InDesign CC and with the use of object states, buttons, actions, and time control, you can better engage your readers, enhance your interactivity, and output to a fixed layout EPUB. So in this InDesign CC tutorial, you will learn how to create and animate an image gallery inside your EPUB to make your workflow more efficient, fun, and elevate user experience. All that with Adobe InDesign CC. So the first step inside Adobe InDesign CC is to convert each of these thumbnail images into buttons. And so I'm going to target this first thumbnail, then click on the Buttons and Forms panel here. And at the very bottom, you can click where it says Convert to Button. Now this is converted to button, but it gives us this generic name. So I'm just going to rename this accordingly to, let's say, thumbnail image 1. Then I'm going to target the second thumbnail photo. Again, I'm going to convert this into a button and give this appropriate name. Definitely that will help you along the way so you have reference to exactly what you're doing. Okay, so we are continuing converting this into buttons. So these thumbnail images will actually reveal the larger Polaroid frames, okay? So we got those five, okay, thumbnail images converted into buttons. And now we're gonna create, as a second step, the five object states for each Polaroid photo. So for that, I'm going to target photo 1 through photo 5. Just make sure that you hold down the Shift key to select only those photos here. And then we're going to click on the Object States panel. I'm going to bring this out here. And then at the very bottom, I'm going to click on the button that says Convert Selection to Multi-State Object. So click on that. It's going to give us this generic name, which I'm going to rename to Polaroid Photo MSO. And by the way, MSO stands for multi-state object. And right now the first object state is photo 5, which actually should be the reversed way. So basically photo 1 should be the first object state. So all I have to do is just bring this up here and rearrange those object states like so. So we got the photo 1, photo 2, photo 3, and we also have the thumbnail images converted into buttons. And on the next step, we are ready to actually create the actions on the buttons. Now, before I continue, let me go ahead first and save our document. So go up to the file menu, I'm going to save this as, and that would be just image gallery. Click to save, there we go. And so let's see, we have the first thumbnail image, which is this one. Okay, this is the first button. This button here will actually go to state. State 1 is the photo 1, this is correct. Then target the second thumbnail image. That will go, the action will go to state, Polaroid MSO photo and photo 2. Okay, thumbnail 3, the action will go to state photo 3, and you get the idea here. Action will go to state photo 4, and lastly, this thumbnail on the action will go to state photo 5. Okay, so let's go ahead and test that using the EPUB interactivity preview here. So under the set preview spread mode, click to play the preview. It's going to build the HTML here. I'm going to click, you see, and everything works the way it's supposed to work, like so. Now let's go ahead and add an animation to each of these Polaroid photos, as well as this corresponding text. So I'm going to target, let's see, the MSO here. It was the photo 1, and under the first object state, I'm going to target the Polaroid photo. There you go. So for that, I'm going to click on this animation panel, and as a preset, click on this drop-down menu, and let's say I'm going to choose fly from top. Here's we get a preview of this animation, flies from the top. Okay, now here we have this animation path. You also have the ability to actually change that path, make it shorter, longer, what have you. So for that, you can use the direct selection tool. Okay, you can click on that. This is the beginning, this is the end. So I'm just gonna bring this just down just a bit, like so. Now we're going to have a shorter animation than the original preset, okay? And now let's go ahead and target the text itself. And for the text, actually, I'm gonna have only fade in, okay? And then I'm gonna do the same thing for each of these object states. First, I'm going to target the Polaroid photo. This one, let's say fly from the left. And for the text, just fade in. And target the third state here. And then target the Polaroid frame itself. Let's say fly from right. And for the text, again, I'm going to choose just fade in, target the fourth object state, and on the Polaroid, let's say I'm going to do fade in actually on that as well, and for the text, fade in as well. And lastly, for the last one, let's see, I'm going to use a preset from fly from the bottom, and then for the text, I will continue using the same fade in. So let's go ahead and preview this inside the EPUB interactivity preview. Press on the play preview here. It's gonna build the HTML. Here's the animation. This also comes animates. There we go. And the last one flies in from the bottom. Now, looking at the EPUB interactivity preview, I want to point out one important detail. So if I press again to build the preview here, notice that the initial object state, this state here, the first object state, the animation does not play. And the reason is that the animation is set to play only on state load. And the state isn't loading the first time around unless we tap on the initial frame again, like so. So the fix here, actually, it's very simple. All you have to do is just duplicate the first state, which is this one, and just remove any kind of animation. So let's go ahead and click and drag this to the new object state button. Gonna bring this up here and rename this, let's say, begin state or whatever you want to call it. Okay, so let's drill into the frame. So under the animation panel, no animation. The same thing for the text. No text is going to fade in as well. So let's go ahead and do another preview here. There you go. Now, this time around, we have the initial state that loads in. Now, this works. This initial object state appears, it will never appear again because none of these thumbnail images as buttons point to that state. So this way users will only navigate between the rest of the other states, the rest of these five states. Like so. See? The last thing I want to talk about is the timing of objects inside each object state. And by that, I mean I want each of the Polaroid photos to appear first and the corresponding text to appear after using a time delay. So for that, we can use the timing panel to change the order of when animated objects play. Okay, so first we need to be on the right object state. So let's see. Let's go ahead and target the MSO. And just make sure that you're not on the beginning state, you're on the first state, which is in this case the photo one. And here is the text. So for the text, you can also target it from here if you wish. I want a delay of half a second, like so. And I'm going to go on the second state, click on the text, add a half a second delay, continue this on the rest of the states, like so. Okay, so I have half a second for all five object states for the corresponding text. Okay, so let's go ahead and preview this here. And let's go ahead and press the preview, and it's going to build the HTML. There we go. Here's the animation, half a second delay. So first the user looks at the main photo, the Polaroid frame, and then the attention is shifted to the corresponding text on the right column. Now inside the iPad, let's go ahead and test the interactivity of the EPUB. The begin state loads first with no animation attached to it, and then whatever we tap on, our image gallery appears with each Polaroid photo appearing first, followed by the corresponding text with half a second delay. Thank you for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.